Hey guys, what's up? This is White Boy for the win, and welcome back to another Pokemon Showdown Commentated Battle. Now, like I said in the previous video, I wanted to actually start doing this series for a couple of reasons, and the main reason is that I want to actually get out of my rust when it comes to competitive battles, because with Pokemon Sun and Moon dropping late this year, I want to do a lot of competitive Pokemon when those games drop, so I kind of want to get I want to work out my rust and do some more competitive plays when it comes to just Pokemon in general before those games drop, because I do plan on doing a lot more competitive battles when it comes to Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon. Now, before we get into this match, I do have to let you guys know that I am basically running on fumes because I've been up for the past 48 hours because yesterday I pretty much had to take my dog to the vet because something was seriously wrong with him. I'm not going to go into too much detail, but pretty much if you guys are going to ask, yes, he's fine. We figured out what was wrong with him ultimately, and we're giving him medicine and all that, so he's going to be perfectly fine. But anyways, I was kind of nervous because I didn't know what to expect, so I was pretty much up all night the night before. I had to take him to the vet, and we went around 8 o'clock in the morning, and when we left the vet, which was roughly around 10 o'clock, I went to my best friend's house, and I was just doing a lot of things over there. And right now, I'm just running on fumes, so if I do sound a little tired, I am. Right now it's already 1:13 in the morning, so I know you guys probably would say I should just wait to record this during the day, but I wanted to get a couple battles out or recorded for you guys because this weekend, when you guys are probably going to be seeing most of these battle videos, I'm going to be very, very busy because I think I have my family coming over, and also I got to go do a couple of things with my best friend. So I'm going to get a couple of these videos out right now. But also, when it comes to these videos, I'm going to have to try to have these videos a little less than 10 minutes, maybe a little bit more than 10 minutes, somewhere around there. I don't want to have these videos ultimately too long, well, except for this one, because I'm pretty much explaining what's going to be going on. Now, I ultimately decide to not do any more live battles when it comes to showdown stuff, because when it comes to doing live battles, the videos will be 30 to 45 minutes long, and I used to do those in the past, and reasons why those videos were so long was because all my opponents that I actually came across, they either thought they were going to lose, so they decided to pretty much just either quit, or they decided to be a dick and just let the timer run out as much as possible, and then when you have 10 seconds left, they decide to go for a move, or their internet's ass and I really couldn't find a really good fast-paced match. So that's why those videos took so long. So I'm going to be doing commentated battles pretty much from now on, because I want to get out of the competitive rust, and I also want to share some battles with you guys. So I think this series is a good opportunity for me to actually do both at the same time. Now, as for when I'm going to be changing teams and stuff, personally, and I decided that I'm not going to be changing teams all that often, because right now, I'm in a competitive rust right now, and this team that I made is actually very well made and also balanced, and I want to work with this team a lot more, so I'm not going to be changing this team anytime soon. So if you guys see any showdown videos, it's probably going to be with this team. So I'm not going to say I'm going to be using this team forever, but at some point I will make a new team and work with that as well. But for now, I want to work with this Mega Lopunny team. So that's pretty much the whole gist of it. Now, I told you guys that these videos were going to be a little over 10 minutes, a little less than 10 minutes here and there, except for this video, because I pretty much had to explain to you guys what's going to be going on and also what happened. But anyways, let's just get right into this this battle right now. Like I said, I do apologize if I just sound out of it. I'm kind of running on fumes, like I said. So let's just get into this match. Now, I decided to lead out with my Heatran because I thought that my opponent was going to lead out with probably his Swampert to set up his own rocks, because I thought we were just going to exchange rocks, but apparently he went out to his Thunderous, went for Thunderbolt, and I did a lot of damage. But I wanted to get my rocks up as soon as possible, but I decided to ultimately go for the Ancient Power just to try to get as much damage off of the Thunderous, because I knew Thunderous is going to be a very big threat. So he decides to switch out into a Swampert. I predicted his switch to go out into his Heracross to probably go for close combat, but I ultimately accidentally missed the fire blast. So he went for his own stealth rocks, and I went to my Latias and used default because I do not want hazards whatsoever, because hazards is going to be a very big problem towards the end of the battle. But I got rid of him, and I decided to go for Draco Meteor to do as much damage, and he's just going to be spamming ice beam. That's perfectly fine, because as like I said, I want to get as much damage off on the Swampert as possible, because I knew I was going to lose my Latias at some point in this match. And pretty much he lived on like 5% because of the leftover recovery. So at this point I decided to go out into my Lopunny, because I know I can get, I can make it evolve and knock it out without using fake out. So I ultimately decided to go for the return, because I knew I outsped, and if he wanted to switch, return was going to do a lot more damage to fake out. But now he goes out into his Thunderous. Now I did not know at least right now that Thunderous carries like Thunder Wave when it comes to like OU, because I know they carried it in like doubles and stuff. So he pretty much used Thunder Wave on my Lopunny, and it pretty much made my Lopunny useless. And he switches out into his Magnezone after his Thunderous die. Went for Volt Switch, and I did around 70%. And he went out to his Latias, used Psych Strike, and pretty much knocked out my Lopunny. So Lopunny was pretty much useless at this point. So I decided to go out into my Clefable, because he had his Latias out, and I knew he was going to switch out into his Magnezone, so I decided to go for the Calm Mind. And this is why I love Fire Blast so much, because I knew he was going to go for a Flash Cannon, and that Calm Mind helped a lot. I used Fire Blast and knocked out his Magnezone, which was a very, very big threat, if I do say so myself. Now, he went out to his Azumarill, and like I said, deja vu, because this happened in the last battle. But anyways, he went for Belly Drum. He was just going to be spamming Aqua Jet, knocked out my Clefable. And Clefable did what he needed to do, which is to knock out his Magnezone. But once again, another deja vu, pretty much stacking off my Gengar again to another Belly Drum, Aqua Jetting Azumarill, because I need to go out into this thing, pretty much live on my Sash and knock it out with either Thunderbolt or Sludge Wave. I decided to ultimately go for Sludge Wave, and then he went out into his Heracross, and I thought this thing was Scarfed, but ultimately it isn't, because at the end it is going to be his Mega Heracross. But I decided to go for the Icy Wind, because I knew he was probably going to knock out my Gengar, and I could freely switch into my Heatran, knowing that I can outspeed. And he decided to switch out into his Latias, and at this point I'm pretty much just going to be sacking off my Heatran, because the only Pokemon I have left in the back is my Dragonite, and I need to save that Dragonite, because it does have the multi-scale. I haven't sent it out in battle yet, and I need to get off of Dragon Dance. So at this point, like I said, I'm just sacking off my Heatran, going for Ancient Powers, hoping to get the boost. But initially I didn't get it, and this Latias left with 1%, which is kind of bullshit. But anyways, I went to my Dragonite hoping he wouldn't go for the Draco Meteor. He didn't. He went for the Psy Strike and knocked himself out, and I got a free Dragon Dance up. And pretty much at this point it's already game, because the only thing he has left is his Heracross. He Mega Evolves, and I went for Outrage, and that is pretty much going to be the game. So anyways guys, thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed this battle, don't forget to hit that like button, and also don't forget to comment and subscribe. Once again, I don't know how like long this video is going to be. Hopefully it's roughly around 10-ish minutes or so, because that's what I plan on having these videos, like the time length for these videos, because I know nobody's going to have a lot of time to just sit there and watch like a 30-minute video most of the time. So these videos are just a little like past time, I would say, for a lot of you guys. And I do enjoy doing these videos, because like I said, I need to get out of the rust when it comes to competitive, because I'm going to be doing a lot of competitive battles when it comes to Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon. So with all that said, like I said, thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that like button, and also don't forget to comment and subscribe. So this is my boy from the Wind, and I'll catch you guys later.